synchronizing interior pressure with exterior atmosphere. Logged. The commanding officer is ashore. Exo Presley has the deck.
We saw your ship. Fidan wants to speak with you immediately.
I've got business of my own to tend to.
The Geth wait for no one. They're preparing another attack. Please, up the stairs past the freighter.
Hostile spotted.
Shepard.
Head to the tunnels. Make sure they're secure.
But what if I find Geth there?
Are you saying you won't go?
We've done it first. The Geth will surely kill us all.
How is a woman supposed to think with guns going off all around?
I fear the Geth will kill us all.
Geth are mounting another attack.
There.
Oh, Commander. I'm glad they finally sent somebody to help us.
You're a bit late, aren't you?
Arcelia. Sorry, Commander. Everyone's on edge since...
Watch out! We've got Geth in the tower!
Protect the heart of the colony!
Kill them all!
I don't want to die! Please, don't let me die!
Update Fidan and get a vehicle safely out of the Normandy. The Geth base is our next objective.
The tower's secure. Thanks to you, Commander.
I'm interested in what Saren sent the Geth to find. Nothing more.
If it's Geth you're looking for, you've come to the right place.
They may have been slowed, but they'll be back. They always come back.
What do they want?
If you want answers, go ask them yourselves.
We don't know what they're after. They came, they attacked us, that's all we know. Their main base is at the ExoGeni headquarters. A good place to start looking if you want answers.
What's ExoGeni?
It's the company most of us work for before the attacks. They fund this colony. The Skyway leads directly to ExoGeni headquarters. You can't miss it.
Of course, there's an army of Geth between here and there.
Every Geth I kill brings me one step closer to Saren.
Then maybe I can get this colony operational again.
What can you tell me about the defenses the Geth have set up?
I don't have any details, but I'll wager it's a lot more fortified than the command post.
They landed at least one Geth ship at ExoGeni, and I've seen large walking tanks on the Skyway. Expect a hard fight.
What do you need done to get this place back on its feet?
We need those Geth destroyed.
Arcelia's right. There are still Geth in the tunnels. We also have more mundane problems like food, water, and power. I'm not sure where we stand on those matters. You should talk to the people overseeing them.
Do you have information about Geth in the lower tunnels?
Nothing new. They're in the tunnel somewhere, likely guarding a transmitter to coordinate attacks. It's not a critical threat right now, but getting rid of that transmitter will help us defend against further attacks.
Let's talk about Zeus, Hope, and Pharos in general.
Of course, Commander.
Tell me about your colony.
Life is hard and often brutal, even without our current problems. Colonial Affairs back on Earth told us we'd be beneath the notice of any raiders. I guess they weren't counting on the Geth. But, despite everything, there's something tranquil about this place, unlike anything I've experienced before.
How big was the original Pharos colony?
We were nearly 1,000 at the main site, 200 more at my outpost. When the first wave obliterated our defenses, we fell back to Zeus Hope.
What else can you tell me about ExoGeni?
ExoGeni funded this colony. Without them, we wouldn't be stuck here.
They specialize in colonization. In return for bankrolling the colony, we work for them. Their main goal is the retrieval of valuable artifacts or resources.
Except there isn't anything here. Or if there is, we didn't find it.
I wonder if that's what the Geth are looking for.
Perhaps. As she said, we never found anything of value.
Of course, the Geth could know something we don't.
I'll talk to you when I learn more.
Good luck, Commander.
Hello, Off-Worlder. I'm glad that we aren't totally forgotten by the rest of the galaxy.
Dear, please try to rest. You're not ready to speak.
But they should know. I mean, they are very important. Yes. That's better.
I'm not gonna catch anything from you, am I?
I'm fine. I just need to try to think clearly. It's just a lingering pain from the last attack. I'll be fine.
I can't see any significant damage, but something is clearly causing her pain.
Please, just let her rest. She just needs rest.
You're the one who repelled that last wave. They'll be back. And if the Geth don't kill us, we'll die of hunger soon enough.
Are you doing anything to remedy the situation?
I need to boost rations with Varan meat, but it's too dangerous. The Alpha Varan, he's huge and he's mad. Rabid, maybe. Totally uncontrollable. I can't do anything until he's dead.
Tell me about hunting Varan.
Hunting them is impossible while fending off the Geth. On the positive side, they'll attack anything. Even those damn synthetics. The big Alpha Varan is the real problem. He's mad, erratic, completely unpredictable.
Tell me about yourself.
What's to tell? I came here with my wife Greta, looking for adventure, a new life together. This isn't exactly what we signed up for. Of course, it would be much better without the Geth. We were really starting to enjoy the colony before they came.
Tell me about Zeus Hope.
The colony is growing. Or it was. But you should speak with Phaidan. He is our leader.
Why should I speak with Fidan? Why can't you tell me?
I don't want to talk about that right now. Speak with Fidan.
I have to go.
So long, Commander.
Nice work with those Geth. Glad you showed up. I still need the power cells for this generator, though.
If I find anything while I'm looking around, I'll send it your way.
Thank you, Commander. I appreciate it.
I'm sorry, but I can't stop to talk. I have to deal with the water shortage.
Is there anything I can do?
The utilities building was one of the first to fall under Geth control. Find the mains and turn them back on. Until then, this colony is dry.
Tell me about yourself.
I'd rather not. This is not the time or the place. Please, help us or don't. Otherwise, leave me to my work.
You know where to find the problem with the water.
The colony can't afford to lose any more of us. We're just too vulnerable.
You're very focused on the water despite the constant attacks.
I can't think of anything else. So much has happened, but it hurts. If I stay focused on this task, the pain goes away.
An understandable reaction, though her discomfort seems almost palpable.
I have to go.
I wish you luck.
Commander, I was told to make my supplies available to you, if you wish.
What can you tell me about Zhu's Hope?
A fascinating place, by all accounts. Though the Geth have made it treacherous. You might like it here too, if you gave it a chance, Commander. I never thought I'd stay in one place for long, but here? I will stay here.
This place is barely holding together. Why stay here?
I can't give you an answer to that, Commander. At least not one that you would comprehend. Why not try asking Fidan? Maybe he can tell you what I can't.
What's a Solarian doing on a human colony?
This Solarian goes where the credits are. Or I did. A well-stocked freighter can be a profitable investment on a new colony. But once I was here, I decided to stay on. The colony life grows on you after a while.
What's your name, Solarian?
My full name is Gorot Tu Heranon Maldinest God Inost Ledra. Humans usually employ surname and given name only. Inost and Ledra, in my case.
Why is your name so long?
We are named for our origins. Gorot Tu is my homeworld, Heranon my clan's country, Maldinest and Got are the city and district where I live.
Let me see what you have.
Of course. I may be able to provide a few interesting items.
That's the last of them.
Thank you.
valve looks like part of a large system. There are likely others we need to activate as well.
There's another one. Doesn't look like it's been activated yet, though. We should keep looking.
Turning this last valve appears to have activated the system, Commander.
You don't want to go down there.
You're not stopping me.
Maybe I will stop you. How would you like that? No! That was a good one. Very intense.
What's the matter with you?
Just invoking the Master's whip. Helps remind me I'm still alive. You're here for the Geth, aren't you? You're not the only one interested in those things.
Who else is looking for the Geth?
Not looking for. Looking to get rid of. They're a thorn in the side of the... Trying to get to the... Dying!
Just leave him. He is completely mad.
Maybe I should just put him out of his misery.
I've thought about that several times. I'd rather die fighting.
I could help you if you told me what you're fighting.
Not that kind of fight. It's like running through a thorn bush. The more you struggle, time's up. Company's coming. Ask Fidan. Ask him about the... Ah!
Look out!
Heads up!
Secure.
All targets eliminated.
How much more I can take?
Perimeter clear. Still can't get a fix on.
Any sign of movement? Lisbeth could still be in there. It's only been a few days. She's my daughter. I'll wait as long as I have to.
We must be close.
Forget them. We need to deal with the Geth.
Heading to position.
That's close enough!
Relax, Jong. They're obviously not Geth.
Get back, Juliana. Who are you? What do you want?
I suggest you put that weapon down unless you're ready to use it.
Don't worry about him. He only cares about the company.
And you trust too easily, Juliana.
I'm just glad to see a friendly face. I thought we were the only humans left on this planet.
Fidan and some of the members of Zeus Hope are still alive.
I thought you said they were all dead.
I said they were probably all dead.
They're surviving, but the Geth really hit them hard.
We know what that's like. Those damn synthetics are relentless.
Are we getting close to their base?
You're almost there. They're holed up in the Exogeni headquarters, just a bit further down the skyway.
Those headquarters are private property, soldier. Remove the Geth and nothing else.
I'm not interested in your company's secrets.
Commander, before you go, my daughter, Lisbeth, she's missing.
They shouldn't waste time poking around. We could do a proper accounting of our casualties after the Geth are gone.
That's my daughter you're talking about. She's still alive. I know it.
Where's your daughter, Juliana?
She was working in the Exogeni building when the attacks came.
Oh, yeah, there were several places she could hide. For a short time.
How did you get split up from the Zeus Hope colony?
Most of us lived closer to the Exogeni building. Zeus Hope was mostly used as a port. When the Geth hit, we scattered. Until you told us about the others, we assumed they were killed in the first wave. If we had known they were still alive, we might have attempted to join them.
They're fairly secure now. Maybe you should do that.
No. I don't think that's a good idea. We have no vehicles, and the Skyway offers little protection.
Like the building we're in now?
Listen, our best hope is to sit tight and wait for company reinforcements. They'll come eventually.
Do you know what the Geth are after?
I have no idea. We certainly haven't found anything of use. Something Exogeni is keen to remind us of.
We need to recoup our expenses. It's nothing personal.
Tell me about the colony.
We established ourselves here 4 years ago. Growth was steady until the attacks. Our biggest challenge has been the lack of resources. There's just so little here of value. Still, we were making a go of it. It was even starting to feel like home.
What brought you here?
I guess I thought this would be the start of a new life. I wanted to go where I could feel like I was making a difference. Instead, everything we built is destroyed. It's very hard not to lose hope.
Where's your daughter, Juliana?
Somewhere at the Exogeni headquarters, I hope.
What was the building used for?
Oh, yeah, we repurposed that structure to serve as headquarters for Exogeni. That's mostly offices with a number of light-duty R&D labs.
Exogeni is a master at repurposing anything and everything.
The company has to make a profit somehow, Juliana. Pharos is a long way from self-sufficient.
Stay bunkered down until I find out what the Geth are after.
Of course. And please remember, if you see my daughter...
I was hoping you'd have a moment to speak with me. I've got a bit of a problem.
Everybody wants something. Hurry up about it.
Fair enough. I need to retrieve some data. It's not a big job, but it pays well.
I'm listening.
Good. Good. Poking around in the ruins has become a bit too dangerous for me.
People are quick to assume we enjoy being in hazardous situations.
It's not that bad, really. All you need to do is find my console at Exogeni headquarters and drop the data onto this OSD. It's that simple.
You're awfully quick to trust me with this.
Have you seen anyone else heading to Exogeni lately?
I'll look around if I get the chance.
I appreciate it. That data could be worth a lot of money. Of course, this all depends on getting out of here alive.
Tell me about the data I'm getting for you.
Plans for a few prototype mods? I'm a freelancer. Some of my mods are highly sought after.
Why work in the middle of nowhere if your skills are so useful?
Maybe I've got a bit of the frontier spirit in me. That, and the alternative is a bit too secure for my liking. Freelancers don't have to worry about security as much, so long as we keep a low profile.
Why work in the middle of nowhere if
Maybe I've got a... Freelancers don't have to worry about security as much.
Do you have any idea what the Geth were looking for?
That's for smarter men than me to figure out. I have no idea what anyone would want with this ruin.
Time to get moving.
Just keep in mind what I said.
The Geth have moved in rather quickly.
They must want something from the Exogeni systems. Why else would they bother with all this?
Thank you. early trip down, Commander Shepard. Damn it! I'm so sorry. I thought you were Geth, or one of those Baron.
Who are you and what are you doing in here?
It's my own fault. Everyone else was running and I stayed to back up data. Next thing I knew, the Geth ship latched on and the power went out. I was trapped. I tried to get out, but the way was blocked.
I'll fight my way through the Geth soon enough.
It's not the Geth, it's the energy field they put up. They don't want anyone else getting access to the...
I'm here for the Geth. If you know something, tell me.
I don't know for certain, but I'm guessing they're here for the Thorian.
Thorian? I have never heard of such a thing.
It's an indigenous life form. Exogeny was studying it.
I need more information. I need to know why the Geth are after this Thorian.
I might be able to, but not with those Geth crawling around everywhere. Look, we need to get out of here, past that field.
Any suggestions?
No, not exactly. But I think the Geth ship is powering it. I've noticed the Geth laying power cables everywhere. You could follow those cables, but there's Geth all over the place.
Tell me about yourself.
I'm just a research assistant for Exogeny. I came here with my mother. I don't even know if she made it out alive.
She's with some others from the colony. She's safe for now.
She's alive? Oh, thank God. I thought I was the only one left. Please, Commander, just get that field down so I can see my mother again.
Tell me what you know about the Thorian.
I really don't know that much about it. I think it's some kind of plant being. I know it's very old. Thousands of years, even.
Why do you think the Geth would be interested in the Thorian?
It's just a plant. I don't know why the Geth would care. Exogeny was studying it, but I don't think they found anything special.
You stay put. I'll go open some doors.
Oh, here, take my ID. This should get you past any locked doors. Good luck with that field.
I don't want to review protocol.
I am unable to comply. Please contact your supervisor.
Damn it! Tell me what I want or I'll blast your virtual ass into actual dust!
Please contact your supervisor for a level 4 security exemption or make an appointment with...
Stupid machine!
If there is nothing else, please step aside. There is a queue forming behind you for the use of this console. Exogeny Corporation reminds all staff that the discharging of weapons while on company property is strictly forbidden. Welcome back, Research Assistant Elizabeth Bainham. What can I do for you?
What information was the last user attempting to access?
Fetching data. The previous user was attempting to access details on the study of Subject Species 37, the Thorian.
Tell me everything you told the Krogan.
I was unable to provide the previous user with any relevant data. Aside from lacking proper access, there has been no new data available on Species 37. All sensors monitoring the observation post at Zoo's Hope have been inactive for several cycles.
What does Zoo's Hope have to do with the Thorian?
Species 37 is located within the substructure of the Zoo's Hope outpost.
Tell me everything you know about the Thorian.
The Thorian is a simple plant life form that exhibits a sentient behavior uncommon with other flora. Through dispersion and the eventual inhalation of spores, it can affect and control other organisms, including humans. The Zoo's Hope Control Group has yielded interesting results. Before sensors went offline, almost 85% of all test subjects were infected.
Exogeny knew all along what would happen to those people.
It was deemed necessary to assess the true potential of Species 37.
That explains their strange behavior.
You should contact Joker.
Joker! Come in, Joker! Damn it! That field's blocking us.
We must find a way around the field. We must get back to Zoo's Hope.
VI, tell me about the field surrounding the facility.
I have limited data on the Geth. They have effectively blocked all sensors within the facility. I have detected unusual power fluctuations, but am unable to determine the source.
What do you know about the Geth?
I have no specifics on the Geth as they relate to this facility. All sensors have been purposely decommissioned since their arrival.
I want to know about Exogeny Corporation.
Exogeny Corporation is at the forefront of human expansion in the new galactic economy, funding colonial development and securing resource rights to ensure our progress as a species. Further inquiries regarding company policy may be directed to Consumer Information Services during regular business hours.
Who's in charge here? Who organized the research?
All decisions about local resource analysis and acquisition are made by on-site management, deferring to the board of directors only when seasonal quotas are missed or exceeded. Individual employee records are confidential.
Tell me about the Thorian.
Species, the output. Within 21 days, 58% of colonists exhibited altered behavior. Within 28 days, 85%.
Do you know how the creature controls its slaves?
The will subversion manifests as intense pain if directives are ignored. The effect is severe enough that subjects are soon conditioned against even minor thoughts of rebellion. Observation suggests the Thorian views its thralls in a utilitarian way. Care is apparently taken to avoid injuring them, much as a craftsman avoids damaging his tools. As long as no action is taken against the creature's objectives, the subjects are free to pantomime a normal existence until specifically tasked with something.
What's the size of this thing?
The Thorian appears to be a diffused creature. Its cognitive abilities are centered in large nerve bundles, but it receives data from kilometers of meandering tendrils. We have discovered bundles approximately 1 meter in diameter, but these seem insufficient to coordinate the massive sensory potential it possesses. It may simply process such stimulation slowly, or perhaps there is a nerve cluster of a greater magnitude we have not yet encountered.
Is it intelligent? Can I reason with it?
The Thorian does not exhibit the focused behavior of a predator. The release of spores is an act of survival, not aggression. It does trigger advanced behaviors in the humans it enslaves, but we have yet to discover whether it recognizes or is capable of recognizing humans as more than tools. It is sufficiently alien as to defy classification at this time.
Where's the center of this thing?
The Thorian is present as a weave of tendrils across much of the lower surface of Pharos. Observation of enslaved subjects suggests there may be key clusters that are tended by thralls. Unfortunately, direct observation of Species 37 is limited, or non-existent.
Please access my personal files.
Elizabeth Bainham, Research Assistant, Biomedical Division, Security Level 4 Exemption. You are currently under probation due to disagreements with management over established company policy. These sanctions may be lifted if your next evaluation is more agreeable.
What triggered the probation?
You were marked as combative about the operations of the Zoo's Hope Project, specifically regarding the handling of the infected colonists. As a result, you were tasked with monitoring the safety of the colonists for the duration of the observation.
That's enough for now.
Going to standby mode.
Thank you.
The Geth must have anchored their ship to the side of the building with these claws.
Indelicate, perhaps, but very efficient. How do we cut the power if it's coming from the ship?
Could the ship be dislodged? Maybe there's a flaw in one of the other claws we could exploit.
This structure seems to have significance for the Geth. Is it possible they set up this room to serve as a sacred temple of sorts?
Why would a synthetic devote resources to something like this?
Now it gets fun!
Have the needed gear to destroy this claw. We will have to keep looking. Well done. Our way out should be clear now. We can go address this Thorian issue.
Keep your guard up. There still might be a few Geth inside the base.
I repeat, Normandy to shore party. Are you reading? Anyone there? Normandy to shore party. Come on, Commander. Talk to me.
Is that you, Joker? What's going on over there?
We're in lockdown here, Commander. Something happened to the colonists. They're banging on the hull, trying to claw their way inside the ship. They're freaking out.
Keep those colonists away from the Normandy. Gun them down if you have to.
Will do, Commander. We'll fire off a few warning shots. That should send him running.
We're leaving, but let's rid this place of those damn synthetics before we go.
There you are. We should get out of here. I don't think this place is safe.
You said you didn't know about the Thorian. I don't like being lied to.
I was afraid. I wanted to stop the tests, but they threatened me. Told me I'd be next. When the Geth attacked, I stayed behind to send a message to Colonial Affairs. I tried to tell them where to find the Thorian, but the power cut before I could send the message. I never meant for this to happen.
Just tell me where I can find the Thorian. No more lies.
The Thorian is underneath Zoo's Hope, but the entrance is blocked. The colonists covered it with the freighter just before the Geth attacked.
What bothers me is why the Geth were after the Thorian in the first place.
Well, it does have unique mind control capabilities. That's what Exogeny was interested in.
Normandy to shore party, come in.
What is it, Joker?
We're getting a lot of Geth comm chatter. Looks like they're headed your way.
You heard the man. Let's move out.
I'm coming with you. I might be able to help. Undo the mess I helped create.
This is Juliana Bainham of Pharos Colony. Please, help us.
That's my mom! Stop! Stop the rover!
You can't do this, Jong.
Everyone shut up! Let me think.
What's going on?
You won't get away with this.
Get her out of here!
Get away from her, you son of a bitch!
Lisbeth!
Damn it! Come out where I can see you! All of you! Shepard, damn it. I knew it was too much to hope the Geth would kill you. I found some interesting facts about you in the Exogeny database. I know what happened on Akuz. This doesn't have to end like that.
Not this time, Jong. You need to back down and let them go.
You don't understand. It's not that easy. Communications are back up. Exogeny wants this place purged.
This is a human colony, Jong. You can't just repurpose us.
It's not just you. There's something here far more valuable than a few colonists.
You're after the one unique thing Pharos has, the Thorian.
The what?
It's a telepathic life form living under Zoo's Hope. It's taking control of the colonists there. Exogeny knew all along.
You won't get away with this, Jong.
So you keep saying, but nobody's gonna miss a few colonists.
You're a bean counter, Jong. I'm a Spectre. Tell me, how good are those odds?
Spectre, it's a load of crap. There aren't any human Spectres. Right?
Is that really a chance you're willing to take, Jong?
Exogeny will send more assayers. They'll know what happened.
Tell them the Geth destroyed the Thorian.
Yeah, but the infected colonists can't be here when the company men come.
You can't just kill the colonists. It's not their fault.
If you kill only the Thorian, it might be enough to stop the infection. Maybe.
Anything hostile will be eliminated.
There has to be another way.
Maybe there is. Come and talk to me before you leave, Commander.
Just make sure there's no evidence when you're done. You shouldn't be wasting time.
I'm glad you've decided to help us. I think there's a way to avoid killing the colonists.
You've got 1 minute.
I think you could safely use a nerve agent to neutralize the colonists.
Like a gas grenade.
Releasing clouds of nerve gas doesn't seem like a particularly good idea.
It's not like it's weapons grade. The insecticide we use in the grow labs contains trace amounts of tetraclopine, a neuromuscular degenerator. If their nervous systems are already weakened, it may act as a paralyzing agent.
A reduced capacity concussion grenade might suit our needs.
I'm not doing it.
At least take the grenades, so you have the option.
My men will keep everyone safe here. If you're going, it should be soon.
We'll stay out of your way until you clear a path.
Good.
Any luck finding my workstation out in the ruins?
I managed to find the data and transfer it to your OSD.
That's very good news indeed. Thank you.
Just give me my credits and I'll be on my way.
You bet. Thanks for all your help, Commander.
Infection could have altered a human to that extent. I wonder what is going on here.
I want a clean sweep. Nothing hostile lives to take a second shot.
We did acquire nerve grenades from Dr. Bainham. Do you want us to use them?
We don't have time to waste on these people. There's a galaxy at stake.
It is regrettable, but if you say there is no other option, that is just the way it is.
Tried to fight it, but it gets in your head. You can't imagine the pain. I was supposed to be their leader. These people trusted me. It wants me to stop you, but I won't. I won't!
All right, we just need to find this creature and determine what it... That is disturbing.
Nothing's ever simple, is it?
Invaders, your every step is a transgression. A thousand feelers appraise you as meat, good only to dig or decompose. I speak for the old growth as I did for Saren. You are within and before the Thorian. It commands that you be in awe.
You gave something to Saren, something I need.
Saren sought knowledge of those who are gone. The old growth listened to flesh for the first time in a long cycle. Trades were made. Then cold ones began killing the flesh that would tend the next cycle. Flesh fairly given. The old growth sees the air you push as lies. It will listen no more.
I don't argue with plants. Give me what I want, now.
The Thorian is a piece of this world, extending across the land and back through the ages. You can no more kill it than cut the sky. Your blood will feed the ground and the new growth! You must die!
Effect, I believe. A few more and it will be severely hurt.
Thank you.
must die!
I suppose I should thank you for releasing me.
How did you end up inside that thing?
My name is Shiala. I served Matriarch Benezia. When she allied herself with Saren, so did I. Benezia foresaw the influence Saren would have. She joined him to guide him down a gentler path. But Saren is compelling. Benezia lost her way.
You chose to side with Saren. So did Matriarch Benezia.
Benezia underestimated Saren, as I did. We came to believe in his cause and his goals. The strength of his influence is troubling.
Benezia sought to turn the river and was swept away.
Asari matriarchs are among the most intelligent and powerful beings in the galaxy. How could one fall under Saren's control?
Saren has a vessel, an enormous warship unlike anything I've ever seen. He calls it Sovereign. It can dominate the minds of his followers. They become indoctrinated to Saren's will. The process is subtle. It can take days, weeks, but in the end, it is absolute. I was a willing slave when Saren brought me to this world. He needed my biotics to communicate with the Thorian, to learn its secrets. Saren offered me in trade. I was sacrificed to secure an alliance between Saren and the Thorian.
That's what you get for trusting Saren.
Saren is quick to betray his followers, and his allies. Once he had what he needed, He ordered his Geth to destroy the Thorian. Saren knows you are searching for the conduit. He knows you are following his steps. He attacked the Thorian so you could not gain the cipher.
What's the cipher? And why did Saren need it?
The beacon on Eden Prime gave you visions. But the visions are unclear, confusing. They were meant for a Prothean mind. To truly comprehend them, you must think like a Prothean. You must understand their culture, their history, their very existence. The Thorian was here long before the Protheans built this city. It watched and studied them. When they died, it consumed them. They became a part of it.
Just give me some plain answers. Where is the cipher?
The cipher is the very essence of being a Prothean. It cannot be described or explained. It would be like describing color to a creature without eyes. To understand, you must have access to endemic ancestral memory, a viewpoint spanning thousands of Prothean generations. I sensed this ancestral memory, the cipher, when I melded with the Thorian. Our identities merged, our minds intertwined. Such knowledge cannot be taught. It simply exists.
You taught Saren, you can teach me.
There is a way. I can transfer the knowledge from my mind to yours, as I did with Saren. Try to relax, Commander. Slow, deep breaths. Let go of your physical shell. Reach out to grasp the threads that bind us, one to another. Every action sends ripples across the galaxy. Every idea must touch another mind to live. Each emotion must mark another's spirit. We are all connected. Every living being united in a single, glorious existence. Open yourself to the universe, Commander. Embrace eternity. I have given you the cipher, just as it was given to Saren. The ancestral memories of the Protheans are part of you now.
Are you all right? What just happened?
All I saw were more weird visions. It still didn't make sense.
You have been given a great gift, the experience of an entire people. It will take time for your mind to process this information.
We should get you back to the ship where you can be monitored.
I am sorry if you have suffered, but there was no other way. You needed the cipher. In time, it will help you understand the vision from the beacon.
Is there anything else you can tell me about the Thorian?
When the creature enveloped me, I became part of it. But I still don't truly understand it. So alien, so ancient. Its exact age is impossible to know. It measured time differently. 10,000 years of hibernation broken by a few frantic centuries of activity. Its mind was awesome, magnificent. It transcended all classification. And now it is gone.
Don't tell me you feel sorry for that thing.
The Thorian was a unique life form. A sentient being that lived for 50,000 years, maybe more. There is nothing even remotely like it in the known galaxy. I am grateful you saved me from a life of thraldom. Yet I cannot help but feel some sorrow for the loss of such a rare and remarkable creature.
I want to know more about you.
There is nothing remarkable about me. I was merely one of Matriarch Benezia's disciples. For nearly two centuries, I followed her, learning at her feet. When Benezia revealed her plan to join Saren, she gave her disciples a choice. Only those who were willing had to follow her. Many felt her plan was too dangerous, but I believed in her. I thought she could turn Saren away from his insanity. Instead, we joined him in it.
Tell me more about this ship Saren has.
Sovereign is alien. I do not know how it was built or where it comes from. Its design does not match that of any known spacefaring species. It dwarfs any vessel in the Citadel or Alliance fleets. Its weapons are devastating, its defenses virtually impenetrable. With it, Saren believes he is unstoppable.
You said Saren uses it to manipulate his followers.
The indoctrination. There is an energy about Sovereign. You feel drawn to the ship. It makes Saren's arguments more persuasive, more compelling. Spend enough time in Sovereign's presence, and you will lose yourself. There is no other way to explain it.
Is there anything else you can tell me about the Thorian?
When the creature enveloped... Its mind was awesome. Magnificent. It transcended all classification. And now it is gone.
I want to know more about Benezia.
Benezia was greatly respected among our people. A powerful biotic, even for an Asari. She was widely known as a teacher of philosophy and religion. She always sought the paths of peace and harmony. She joined with Saren because she hoped to turn him away from his path of destruction.
Instead, she became one of his most powerful allies.
As I mentioned before, Matriarch Benezia underestimated Saren. Be sure you do not make the same mistake.
What else can you tell me about Saren?
There is little I could tell you that you do not already know. He's powerful, he's charismatic, and he is dangerous. Once I followed him, blind to his true nature. But now I see he's leading the galaxy into an age of darkness and suffering.
You were allied with Saren. For all I know, you still are. I can't just let you walk away.
Your suspicions are understandable. But you freed me from the Thorian and from Saren. I am on your side now. If you allow it, I would like to stay here with the colonists. They have suffered greatly, and I played a role in their suffering. I would like to make amends.
You change sides too often. I have no choice. You must die.
So be it. If this is the fate you feel I deserve, then I will not resist.
I can't believe it. Zhong says we'll have all the money we need to keep this place running. It's because of you, Shepard. I can't thank you.
Commander, you look pale. Are you suffering any ill effects from the Cypher?
My brain's been scrambled like an egg. How do you think I feel?
I might be able to help you. I am an expert on the Protheans. If I join my consciousness to yours, maybe we can make some sense of it.
Do it. Hurry. We don't have much time.
Relax, Commander. Embrace eternity! That was... incredible. All this time, all my research, yet I never dreamed. I am sorry. The images were so vivid. I never imagined the experience would be so... intense. You are remarkably strong-willed, Commander. What you have been through, what you have seen, would have destroyed a lesser mind.
Did you see anything?
The beacon on Eden Prime must have been badly damaged. Large parts of the vision are missing. The data transferred into the Commander's mind is incomplete.
You sure you didn't come across any kind of clue or hint? Something we might have missed?
Everything I saw, you already know. You were right about the Reapers. The Protheans were destroyed by a race of sentient machines. I think it is obvious there is a connection between the Reapers, the Prothean extinction, and the Conduit. But I did not see anything that would help us find it.
Looks like we're back where we started.
Quite the opposite, Commander. I think my knowledge of the Protheans will prove useful before this is over. I was able to interpret the data relayed through your vision, what was there at least, but something was missing. Saren must have the missing information. Maybe he found another beacon.
If we can find the missing data from your vision, I am sorry. The joining is exhausting. I should go to the medical bay and lie down for a moment.
You sure it was the joining? I feel fine.
Your role in our communion is passive. I am the one who must submerge myself in your mind, drown myself in your thoughts. It is more difficult than it looks. The human subconscious instinctively resists the joining, Commander. A strong personality like yours makes it even harder.
We're done here. Dismissed.
I've sent off the Pharos report, Commander. You want me to patch you through to the Council?
Patch him through, Joker.
Setting up the link now, Commander.
Commander, is this some kind of game? Are you calling in a report just so you can cut us off again?
Don't piss me off and I won't disconnect you.
You don't make demands on us, Shepard. Spectre's answer to the Council, not the other way around.
You need to back off and let me do my job.
Of course, Commander. We received your files on Pharos. Things would have been much easier if Exogeni had told you about the Thorian.
You might have been able to capture it for study instead of destroying it.
The only reason to study a creature like that is to figure out how to kill it.
Yes, kill it. That's how you humans usually deal with things you don't understand.
The Thorian enslaved and killed innocent civilians.
Perhaps it's for the best, then. At least the colony was saved.
Of course it was saved. Shepard would go to any lengths to help a human colony.
I never jeopardized the mission.
That's good, Commander. Stopping Saren is your primary goal. Everything else is secondary.
Goodbye, Commander. We will be waiting for your next report.